an age-friendly community is the perfect place for everyone.
The age-friendly community concept is just starting within the HKPR region. We've had a couple of communities who have identified that there has been a need and some local committees that have started up.
Well, age-friendly is the community working together. And it's all aspects, like it's like the extended family, it's the extended community.
I think it's a community that you can grow older in with respect and dignity and still have an opportunity to contribute to whatever level you're able to.
It was identified in one of the community groups that seniors, instead of waiting for change to happen, they agreed that seniors were the solution to some of the needs that were identified. And so instead of waiting for programs and services to take place, they really wanted to hop on board and create the change themselves.
I think we have a history to share and hopefully a little bit of wisdom. And we just need to explore opportunities to have that interaction between the different age groups. So that old saying that we're only as strong as our weakest link, and I think that's important to always remember.
I think seniors are more active. We stay involved for a longer period of time, and I think you're going to see the Zoomers coming along where we're not going to put up with it anymore. You know, we want to be out there. We want to be part. We want to be involved with the younger people, and we are more active, we are stronger. So, and I think we're mouthier too. And I think we should be more involved in allowing people to age in place. There should be housing, better housing for us, because we are lacking. We have a nursing home, but there's not that step between where people are in their own homes and then they can't, you know, get into a smaller home and then move on to that. So we need that stepping.
The ability to access primary health care, like a family doctor or nurse practitioner, to keep me as healthy as I can be, getting older, and appropriate housing when I can't manage my home by myself anymore. So those would be my main concerns at this stage.
So to be age-friendly, I think you need to have that so people can maintain their relationships, maintain their family, maintain their lifestyle within the community. But they need to be also feel that they're useful. So an age-friendly community respects and uses the experience of seniors.
We want to be able to create an environment that is safe and secure so people can age well, so people can feel comfortable and not have to move out of their community. We want to create a place that is beneficial for all.
I think it's important that we get together first as groups of seniors, as older people, to determine what it is that we need to do and what we want to do. And that's what we've been doing with our age-friendly group. And then we look at other areas that can help us with that. Other groups, other funding agencies, New Horizons, the provincial government, the federal government, the local communities. So we're looking at what's available to us. And we're also out there fundraising. When we find that there's something that we want done, find like the Kawartha North Family Health Team. We found that there wasn't any funding for a drop-in clinic, so they're out there fundraising to do that. So not only are we looking for gaps, but we're also working at creative ways. We can do things in a new way.
If you're an individual within the community and if you'd like to get involved in helping to create change and work towards age-friendly communities, we ask that you call the health unit for more information or look for like-minded individuals who might also want to create change as well. And perhaps we could start something in your area.